my friends, we're back. As the time goes by and this situation remains, I'm sure things might be getting more and more challenging for a lot of us. And so I'm sharing with you some tools that I think might help you to overcome or at least lighten up your burdens. And as most of us know, the only solution we can find right now, the only thing that we can change right now is our internal state. And the tool of mantra, as I said before, can come in very handy. We did the Gayatri mantra in the last video, and today I want to share with you a little bit of the technique, or a technique of chanting Aum that I found profoundly useful in many levels. Remember, we spoke of the three centers and the potential of these practices bringing these centers into alignment, the physical, the emotional, the mental, and therefore opening up the door to the higher self or perception or whatever you may want to call it. I call it headquarters. And so the practice of Aum for me also has a tremendous value as a sound healing tool, because I call it a vibrational tool. We are going to actually vocalize Aum in a way that is vibrating our internal organs, our entire system from the bottom up. We're literally giving our internal organs a vibrational massage with the sound of our voice. I won't go into the theory behind Aum. It's fundamental sound in all religions, in all philosophical systems. In the West, Aum turned into Amen or Amin. In the beginning was the word, in the beginning was Aum. There's no need to refresh all of that, and you can always do your own research on it. Today I'm going to be very practical. I like to use an application in my iPad that gives me the sound of this beautiful Indian instrument called tambura. So it's very cheap, you can buy it, and it really supports the practice. So you can look into that, downloading a tambura into your iPad or your iPhone. My application is called iTabla Pro. It also has rhythm, and it has a beautiful, very natural sounding tambura sound. I also use my my Tibetan bowls, or Nepalese bowls to be more accurate. And the practice is, as all good things in life, very simple. We basically, instead of thinking of saying something, we simply open our mouths and slowly close it. And we produce all the possible sounds that our mouth can emit, thus honoring all the possible mysteries of the universe, all the possible trinities, because Aum is considered a bit of a trinity, A-U-M. When we do it internally, it's different, but today we're going to do it externally. So maybe later we can talk about the internal practice. But today is a vibrational practice. So that's the idea. If I open my mouth and slowly close it, what happens? I wasn't thinking of saying anything, I simply open my mouth and slowly close it. Now the trick here, or so to speak, the intentional part of it that really brings the practice deep inside as a healing tool, is for you to really send intentionally that ah down into your body, inside your body. Take that vibration to go inwards. And as you close your mouth, you feel like there's a vibrational elevator slowly vibrating your entire system until the mmm is vibrating your head. You can do it in any give a note you can. Ideally, if you have musical instruments or a keyboard, find a note that feels really comfortable for you. And the tambura in the iPad can be tuned to any note, or if you have an instrument. And if you have no instrument, it doesn't matter. Just whatever note comes out of your body, that's the note for the day. I kind of have lots of instruments around, and so I like to be, so to speak, held by some beautiful sounds, so my sound comes out a little more powerful, I think. So, shall we try it? Do it with me. Basically, we take a deep breath. I mean, of course, I want to be brief here, but ideally you come into a good posture, close your eyes for a second, really make sure your body is relaxed, breathe into all your internal organs with gratitude, relax your muscles before you do this practice. So you're very relaxed. And a mantra is basically an invocation of a specific frequency very often, but in the case of Aum, we're not invoking a specific frequency such as beauty or love or wealth. No, no, no. We're simply invoking literally the genetic, the cellular memory of our oneness with this entire mystery that the universe is. We're all children of this mystery. And so when we start dissolving the layers that may be very strong right now of worry, of fears, of self-image, thoughts, blah, 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 Aum slowly, slowly but surely starts softening these layers and bringing us back to this mystery, to this silence, to this openness, to this spaciousness, to this fragrance of just being. Not being anything in particular, not doing anything, just being. And, you know, the situation is, as painful as it may be, a good opportunity for you to look into your potential capacity for being rather than doing. We very much hide quite often in doing, and when we're forced in a place of silence, in restriction and being, we find that we have very little of that beingness, very little connection with it. So this is a good opportunity. So I will activate my tambura. If you're curious, the note is G. G in Spanish is sol. Sol means sun. It's the note of the sun. And for me, it's kind of a little above the middle, so my voice can be very comfortable. You don't have to consider this a musical exercise, so whatever comes out of your body, don't worry about it. This is not a choral exercise at all. It's a vibrational exercise. So we're going to breathe in, open our mouth, and just close our mouth very slowly as we raise the internal frequency vibration on a physical level of our voice.
Ah.
thing now is about 8 times. Full practice is up to you. You can time it or you can count it. About 12 times feels like a round number. 8 times is a mini session. 15 minutes to half hour is really good. But already haven't done that much. I feel a change. I feel an internal change. I feel an internal silence that has grown a bit. I feel my external, what you would call my energy field, expanded. Less noise in the mind. One thing that I didn't mention that it helps a lot in the practice of Aum is to raise, as you close your eyes, raise your eyes upward as you were internally looking into your third eye. Take a few seconds when you finish each Aum to look into the change that each Aum makes within you. And make sure you're not forcing your voice. Huh? Very important. Turn air into sound. And never force the voice beyond so the sound gets cut off. Try to make a little nice fade out as a DJ would be turning down the volume, so it's very, very smooth. And at the end of the Aum, check in very quickly to see if you have tensed your stomach, your shoulders, your jaw. It's supposed to be a very beautiful, slow process of vibrational healing and relaxation. So I hope you enjoyed this and I hope this helps. Later on we might do another video about the internal practice of Aum, which is very different and has the advantage, of course, of being not only silent, but you can do it anywhere. But of course, as you probably know, Aum is considered the greatest and the most powerful, most essential mantra. But like I said, I won't get into theory. Thank you very much. Hope this helps, and I'll see you soon.